I fucking hit the button and forgot I was on the second I did that. Anyway, cool. Using my keyboard. Alright! Y'all read the title, y'all know what's up. A couple of things I want to get out of the way before we start the build. Happy New Year! Woo! Originally I did plan on doing this like on New Year's Eve or something, but the timing didn't really work. I wanted to do some stuff with my family, so you know, that's how it is. So this is actually a Motoroid kit, which we haven't built before, if I can recall. The Motoroid line is, of course, an extension of a Good Smile company, which they do make a lot of sick products and stuff. They're mostly known for, I think, the Nendoroid line, which is kind of like a Funko Pop, but with like more effect parts and like more poseable. Hey, Carnes! I missed your stream earlier today, but I'm gonna try and catch it later. I didn't see it when I clicked the extension, but you know, I saw that you streamed earlier today, so try and catch that later. Anyways, so back to the kit. The Motoroid line is like, it is trying to emulate the Kotobukiya Bandai style. Unfortunately, from peeking the manual during pre-assembly, I did see that there are a couple parts that, you know, require, or thought to require glue and stuff, so maybe we'll have to glue a few things together just to complete the build. Hopefully nothing too strenuous or whatever. The box design is interesting. Normally they put the box over and then you pull this out of the bottom, but it's like an actual box, so I just want to show that off a little bit. It's the same on both sides, and then the back is different, and then the end and end here. So I didn't see that. So the end here, let me fix the camera. So the end here, that's not fitting in the frame. End here is different. Normally you just get the one crisp image on both sides, but it's different here. So I don't know if I'm gonna probably cut this box or not, because I can't really store it with the box cut. Not sure how I'm gonna rectify that. Yeah. You have cool, like, some of the iconic poses and stuff. I'm just gonna lift this up. You have some of, like, the iconic poses and stuff from the kit. Anyways. This kit is also very special to me because, I don't know, I think I had a feeling that the first Pat Labor kit we made, the Ingram, it was a much older looking kit, despite the initial release date that I thought it was, which ended up being wrong. I don't know why they had that on the HobbyLink Japan website. I thought it was a 2013 release, but it was like 1980-something. So obviously the quality wasn't there. This is a bit more modern. I think it was either 2019 or 2021? Something like that. I don't know, like the license for Pat Labor stuff, suddenly it's up in the air and everybody's making their own Pat Labor kit. I kind of wanted to take a look at the Aoshima stuff, but they didn't really have any designs that I wanted to look at. Nothing new or whatever. So Peacemaker is obviously something, a design I very much enjoy. It's actually interesting in the lore of the show and in the first original movie. It's actually, technically it's the Zero and the Peacemaker. The Zero was like the villain of the first movie. And then in the anime show, the Peacemaker is the successor to the Ingram, making it the third generation police use mecha, which is always fun to say. So yeah. I'm sure I've talked a lot about Pat Labor during the first video. It was so long ago, I don't remember it. I don't really have a whole lot to say, although I'll probably think of some stuff. So without really much else in the way, I want to start the build now and get it over with soon, because I have a lot of free time on my hands, but I'm going to use that free time to build other kits and stuff that are coming up. I just released a Model Kit Wave 7. There are like 16 or something kits in there that I want to get done quick, so that we're not spending like a whole year on that one box. And yeah, let's get into it. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
that's going to do it for me. Obviously, there are some weird glaring issues here that I need to rectify, and if I can, I'll post something in the Discord chat. But I was really happy with the build and the assembly process. It's definitely better than the old, like, 1990 whatever, high-grade Ingram kit we looked at. But how much better? Enough that I would still recommend this over that. But I don't know. Still need to look out on those things. So yeah, hit me up on the Discord if I ever find out what's up with that. I'll tell you there. Follow me live on Twitch. We got plenty of other models and video games to play over there live. You can talk to me while that's going on. If you miss any of it, catch me up on the YouTube. All kinds of videos and stuff are there from the years worth of content we've amounted. And yeah, without taking up too much of more of your time, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, keep on dreaming. Poutine out. Peace.